Hi guys, how's it going? Yeah, like you said, we are the football team. Opposed to popular belief, our performance is going to be on point, very accurate, and it's about the evolution of man, so here we go. All right, in 1924, a scientist named Raymond Dart discovered the pint-sized skull and bones of a creature that had both ape-like and humanoid features. Dart labeled this bipedal find Australopithecines. In 1974, an archaeological team working at a site in present-day Ethiopia unearthed a relatively intact skeleton of a young adult female, Australopithecine, in the valley of the Awash River. The researchers who found the skeleton gave the skeleton the nickname Lucy. She's still a little over 3 feet tall. It is important to emphasize that Australopithecines were not humans, but that they carried the genetic and biological material out of which modern humans would later emerge. The first stage of evolution of man were the early hominids. Early hominids got their food primarily from hunting. And also from gathering. The second stage of the evolution of man is known as Homo habilis. Dated at roughly 2.8 to 1.5 million years ago, artifacts have been discovered that show at this time early humans have begun to make tools. Unlike other tool-using animals such as chimpanzees, early humans were now intentionally manufacturing tools rather than just finding them when needed. In addition, these early humans began to pass knowledge onto their offspring and continue to improve their tools, which early early humans the name of Homo habilis, or skillful man. Some of these tools were used for hunting small animals. And for butchering them. These were the first forerunners of modern humans.
Next on the evolutionary ladder was Homo erectus. The variation in height shows that this species was closer to the current humans in terms of size. This group is also believed to be the first group to have migrated out of Africa. This was due in part to their bigger brain, but mainly their use of fire. Homo erectus is often rewarded with being one of the first groups to use fire. It allowed them to boil and cook otherwise indigestible foods. They were then adapted to different climates and environments within Asia. Every changing attribute or action was bringing the species one step closer to their present state.
The final stage of the evolution of man were the Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens, who are often regarded as the first modern humans, were a bigger brain and more agile species. Their distinctive traits, which included greater cognitive skills, allowed them to flourish and reproduce. Because their ability to adapt to new environments and innovate, these migrants became the first discoverers of America.
Hey.
Although we're Homo sapiens, we're somewhere two other hominids in that they live by hunting and gathering. Their use of language and new cultural forms represented an evolutionary breakthrough.
Hey. Cat.
Language gave individuals the ability to teach words and ideas to neighbors and offspring, and therefore it enhanced the ability to accumulate knowledge. The ability to draw also set Homo sapiens apart. It allowed them to understand their environment, bond to their kin groups, and to articulate important mythologies. After thousands of years of evolution, we have come to the pinnacle of human development.
Yeah, well, I'm doing a presentation now.
We have one more.
My real name or by our
real name?
I'm Alex Staff.
Matt Dickerson.
Brad Suchowski.
Dylan Luther.
Christian Worthy.
Thank you.
Thank you.